All packed and loaded. Ready to go fishing. It's 5 o'clock. We're filling up gas, heading out for a weekend of fishing. You awake, Eric?
Yeah, just getting there.
Hey guys.
Good morning. Beautiful sunrise. We're in Lewiston, Idaho, on our way to fish for steelhead for a couple days. It's gonna be amazing. Thanks for tuning in. Should be a great episode, all gonna be shot in 4K. We're a little hungry, we're gonna go get some Jack in the Box, and expecting a grand adventure over the next 2 days. I might break this into a two-part video series. Adventure on. Check it out. Here's our digs for the night. There's actually two bunk beds.
Does the toilet work?
It does.
Hey, we got a working toilet. Yeah. What do you think of the digs?
It's like 5 stars as far as I can tell.
I mean, humble, simple, with a couple of bunk beds.
Yeah, it looks warm and better than a tent.
And we're gonna go meet Dave.
Yeah.
Meet up with the drift boat and start fishing. The reports have been good. The guy just told us that they've been catching fish just exactly where we're going in the last couple of days. So the odds are good. Let's go catch some fish.
Perfect, buddy.
Kind of a fun view. Mm-hmm. We got the river dog here. Little topaz for good luck. She does pretty good on the boat.
How
are
you doing?
What's going on, Eric? This is pretty exciting.
It is. We're all bundled up.
Being hauled around by Super Dave here.
No, I love nymphing for steelhead.
Okay.
But we're gonna definitely swing some spots. I like to nymph in between the runs that we're gonna swing and take some time and swing a couple spots.
Awesome. So we'll be able to get out of the boat, what, 2, 3, 4 times a day if we want to, kind of thing, right?
Yeah, we are gonna get out at least 2 to 3 times.
Awesome.
Maybe more. We can get out as many times as we want.
Really. Well, Eric.
Nice. 7-8 miles.
Have our
leftovers.
Yeah.
Cool.
Do you need a string of rods at all?
I mean, I was kind of going to wait.
I would do it now, yeah, while I'm dealing with this.
Okay. Hey, I'm gonna tell me when you want us to cast.
One, two, three, J.
jumping off the porch like mom's not home. Tell me why the best things feel so wrong. Summer nights, love them how they take so long. Run with the feeling of being alive while we're still jumping off the porch like mom's not home. Just a couple kids living on our own. Summer nights, love them how they take so long. Run with the feeling of being alive while we're still young.
Good morning. Woke up in this little cabin here. It's pretty cool. Staying the night right on the river you're gonna be fishing the next day. Yesterday was a ton of fun. Rendered no fish, unfortunately, but the scenery, the element of friendship and making memories with David and Eric, can't beat that. That's all awesome. So grateful. There's also the component of this adventure of the challenge of catching a steelhead. And so today is day number 2. Eric and I are going to take our chances of walking and wading, meaning we don't have a boat, so we're going to hit some different holes, try a couple different things, hopefully catch a fish. Dinner was delicious. We had Hawaiian burgers, and then this morning we'll see how they do with their breakfast. But any thoughts on the food last night?
Man, it was the best burger. I don't know if it's because we were so darn hungry, but it was really good.
It was great. So all right, let's see if we can go to the adventure.
Fix my ear. Look at me.
And what about you guys?
Okay.
You ready?
Yes, definitely.
Okay.
I'll do the campers. Okay. Eggs over medium.
Okay.
And was ham one of the choices?
We have ham. Yeah. I don't remember what the campers is. Sorry. Okay. So, and for you?
I'm going to do the same.
The same. So, campers, over medium, eggs. And... That's it.
Okay, it's one of my favorite times in the world. It is time to fish. Let's go get them. The objective today is kind of two part. One is to catch fish. The other is to document the catching of fish through high quality technology mediums. What do you think about that, Eric?
I think a lot of it.
We got the drone, we got the DSLR. Couple of GoPros, tripods, everything going okay there for you, boss? So tighten up the belt.
Oh, I got a piece of fabric.
Oh, there you go.
There we go.
The photographer, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, there we go.
Let's go.
Be able to reach the on and off button.
Okay.
So maybe put it in a pocket.
Put it in a pocket where I can hit the on and off button, attach the clip, and we'll get audio. Awesome. Let's do this. Eric and I have been going at it here for about 3 hours. Been filming some really cool stuff too with the drone, and I think right now he's got the big camera, and we're testing out the audio technology here. Some refer to steelhead fishing as the fish of 1,000 casts. I've heard it more recently said a fish of 10,000 casts. So we have high hopes. We're fishing a couple of nymphs right now. Chartreuse with black stonefly, about 8 to 10 feet under an indicator with a trailer fly, a little chartreuse yarn style egg pattern. Fishing two flies. But cannot seem to elicit a bite today. Was that cool? Can't be Denty more stew. So hey, we've seen a couple eagles today and now some bighorn sheep. This is super cool.
Yeah, it's really nice to see.
Is this like a 400 or something? Or?
Yeah, it's a 1 to 400. That's completely out of focus.
I'm gonna hold that for you.
But Eric's decided to put the camera on the tripod to steady up the video. We'll see if we can capture these bighorn sheep in a way that might be interesting to show. How's it looking, buddy?
Hey, can you tell if this is focused? Or I can just put on my glasses, but I don't have them. Take a look at this and see if it's focused.
Really cool having this wildlife encounter just right next to the car. All right, cool, man. Thanks for giving us this opportunity to check these bighorn sheep out, boss.
Just finished another day. Here in the Grand Ronde. Joel's down there fishing the last hole here. Nice cast, Joel.
Eric's up there waving at me. We're gonna call it a day. No fish this trip. Sometimes it's like that, you know? And we had an incredible time. Lots of casts, lots of opportunities. Eric thinks he hooked one here at the end of the day, but it broke the hook actually, which is pretty uncommon. It didn't even break the knot. It broke the actual hook itself. I'll see if I can, we tried to save it, but it fell down. The little remains of the hook fell in the rock, so we don't have that. Thanks for tuning in and hanging out with Eric and I on another awesome episode of Fish and Fly with Gus. Next time we'll have some fish in the net, but we're doing our very best, our absolute best to catch some fish and capture them on camera. But we can only do so much. The fish have to do their part too. So on that note, we'll see you on the next episode. Adventure on.
Today, jumping off the porch like mom's not home. Tell me why the best things feel so wrong. Summer nights, love them how they take so long. Run with the feeling of being alive.